Hello friends, how are all of you? This is your friend Manak from Civil Center and I welcome all of you to another video tutorial on your Tekla Structural Designer. So friends, many of us, our students and our viewers have requested to make a video on how to design slab in Tekla Structural Designer. So everyone knows how to assign a slab. We had also shown in our previous videos how to do the modeling, how to apply the loading. But the problem which students face is to apply your loop, is to design your slabs economically in Tekla Structural Designer. So we'll see that. So for that, as you can see, we have a G+2 building model and the model is complete. So we'll just design the slabs. So for designing the slabs, we need to have two checklists. One is your design settings. We'll go to the design and then we'll just check the design settings. So in the design settings, you need to check the design settings for your patches, reinforcement layout and general parameters. So in the design settings of reinforcement layout, we'll just check this minimum loose bar size, maximum loose bar size, I'll make as 12 mm. And then the minimum clear spacing is 100, so okay. Maximum clear spacing is 150. And maximum principal bar spacing, I'll do as 150. Minimum secondary bar spacing also I'll do as 150. So these changes I'll make. And if you're designing flat slab, you can also make changes in the flat slab as well. I'll not design flat slab right now. So in the patches also you can change the size of these patches, wall patch, panel patch. So I have done this much change. You can do as per your conditions. So next we can click on OK here. So after clicking on OK, next thing is to check for your governing span. So in any particular span, the governing span is the shorter span. Suppose we have this particular span here. This is your governing span, which we can measure in this particular software as well. So in this particular slab, the governing span is 3.175. So let us find out the maximum governing span in this particular building. So we have one here, this one, this slab is at the maximum spans. Let's just check this. This is 4.013 and this is your 4.648. So let's take 4.1 as the governing span. You can check each and every slab and you can find in the shorter side and you can take the governing span as the maximum of your shorter side here. For now, here I can take 4.1. So I'll just open our calculator to show you. So this is 4.1 and as per IS 456, effective depth equals effective span by modification factor into basic value. So we'll take those values here. Let's take modification factor of 1.4 and your basic value as average of simply supported and continuous, that is 23. So we have 127 here. So let's say 130. So let's say we have 130 mm here, 130 mm plus your overall depth will be effective depth plus effective cover. So effective cover, let's take as 20. So we'll have 150. So approximately we can give depth of slab as 150 mm. So we'll select the entire structure and then we'll go to select slab items. And after that, we'll just change the depth of this particular slab as 150 mm. So after we've done 150 mm, the next step is to go in each and every level and apply your patches. So why do you apply patches? Because there are some extra moments which are generated at the intersection of your columns and your slab. So for that, you need to first go to your results view. So after going to your results view, we can select here a particular load combination which we want. So we have selected load combination and then we'll select FE analysis here, FE chase down, and then we'll switch on the 2D results. And in the 2D results pane, we'll just switch on the results. So after that, we can just check the MDX top and the MDY top to get an idea of your movement. So as you can see at all the intersection of your columns and slab, we have some movements. So now we'll apply some patches to compensate for those. So for applying patches, the procedure is you can go to the design. After going to the design, you can just select here any particular patch which you want to apply. You can select on patch column, you can select on patch beam or patch panel or patch wall, which is for shear wall. So we'll select patch wall here and then just click on the entire structure as we want to patch all the columns. And we have some, we can patch some beams here as well, this beam and this beam. So we have patched those beams and columns. Now we want to repeat the same step in all the floors. So for that we'll go to levels, and in one we have already done, let's do it in two as well. So we can go to our results view and then we can just go to our design patch column, apply our patches, and then patch beams, apply patches to these two beams, and then our last level, our results view, and then you all will go to our design patch columns and we'll patch two beams similar to what we had done earlier. So now we'll go to the structure 3D and then we can just go to the scene content here and turn off the slab patches. Okay, we have turned off the slab patches. Now we can go to our home and then design, and then we'll just click on design slabs. Please note that we had already analyzed the model before, so we don't need to analyze it. But if you haven't done, first you need to do the design and analysis of the model, and after that you can proceed with all the steps which we have mentioned. So we'll go to design slabs. So as you can see, all the slabs have been saved here. Now you can just click on a particular slab and then you can just check for the report of the member. So in the report of the member, as you can see, these slabs are going as safe at 8 mm at the rate 150 center to center. So this is your right way to design your particular slab in Tekla Structural Designer software. So if you also want to design your patches, you can also do that. We'll just show you in the upcoming video how to design those patches. For now, you have learned how to design your slab effectively and economically in Tekla Structural Designer. So for more such videos, stay tuned to our channel. And if you want to get trained from us practically in this software, and if you want to know how to design a building in Tekla Structural Designer, we have a course for you, that is G+3 Building Design using Tekla Structural Designer. You can join that. And if you want any other trainings, also you can just check your comment which is pinned, and you can register for live trainings on projects from Civil Center. So that's all for today. Please like this video if you found it useful, and also do comment, because from your comments only we get to know which topics you are interested in. Bye bye.